Hi viewers, this is me Slasher and you're watching educational channel Slasher Education. So guys, from Nelson Mathematics 2 and 3, Chapter 1, Algebra, page number 3. So today's our topic is factor theorem. In my previous lecture, I taught the remainder theorem. So let me have a short preview. 12 is the dividend, 4 is the divisor, and the answer is 3, which is quotient. This is dividend, this is divisor, and this is quotient. Now what is the remainder theorem? The 4 is dividing here. On the other side of the equation, it will be multiplied to 3. 3 multiplied by 4, and so both sides of the equation are true. But if I divide 12 by 5, it means 12 is the dividend, 5 is the divisor. Now what will be my quotient? 12, 5, 2, 10, and hence 2. So 12 divided by 5 is equal to, I'm going to send 5 to the other side of the equation. It means 2 multiplied by 5 plus 2. 2 multiplied by 5 is equal to 10 plus 2. It means that both sides of the equation are again equal. This is the dividend. 5 is the divisor. 2 is the quotient. Plus remainder. This was our remainder theorem. But if I divide if the dividend is going to divide by such a divisor where its answer should where there's no remainder, it means if the remainder is zero, that's a factor theorem. Let's have its general form. Let's look towards the general form of the factor theorem, which is f of x is a polynomial function. Suppose if it is, and this is the linear expression which you are going to put the value in it. So x minus a is equal to 0, x is equal to a. It means the value of x is a. I'm going to put this in this expression. If your remainder is 0, it means that that is the factor theorem. Let's look toward an example from the book. From Nelson Mathematics. They give us a polynomial function of x power 4 minus 3x cubed minus 3x square plus 11x minus 6 divided by this linear expression x minus 3. What if I take this linear expression equals to 0? So the value of x is 3. Now I'm going to replace x by 3. So f of 3 is equal to 3 power 4 minus 3 into 3 cube minus 3 into 3 square plus 11 into 3 minus 6. So f of 3 is equal to, this is 81, this is 3 into 27 minus, this is 9, and this again makes 27 plus 33 minus 6. This and this cancelled each other because this is a positive 81 and this is a minus 81. So now let's minus 27 minus plus negative negative makes positive. It means that we are going to add up, but the sign should be of the greater number. It means the greater value, which is in the negative, the smaller number is the bigger one. So minus 33 plus 33. So I'm going to cancel them out. So I have no remainder, and no remainder means zero. If I divide a polynomial function with such an quadratic or the linear expression where I will find no remainder, it means that this is the factor theorem. If you want to divide this by the linear expression, you will have the same thing. Now what formula should apply to this? In the remainder theorem, we just add the remainder at the other side of the equation, like divisor, dividend, quotient multiplied by the divisor plus remainder. This is the remainder theorem. Now just need to remove this. This is our factor theorem. Let me repeat again. Such a polynomial function which is going to be divided with such a linear expression or the quadratic expression where you will find no remainder, it means that is the factor theorem.